In this video, we are going to explore how we can create realistic 3D light rays for both motion graphics and footage. We are in After Effects, and for this first scene, we're going to have a look at this 3D cube motion graphics scene. You can see how we can create this in a link in the video description below. You can see a tutorial for this. And we're going to see how we can add volumetric light to this 3D cube. When adding volumetric light to motion graphics, it is a little bit different than when adding it to footage. So keep tuned even for the footage part to see how that will differ. So let's start with this one. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to add a small in here sphere that we can emit light from. To do that, I'm simply go to the ellipse tool in here, and in this scene, I'm going to draw a small ellipse like that. I'm going to center it, and I'm going to position it right below the faces in here. I'm going to toggle these switches and turn it to 3D, just like that. I'm going to rename this light. Wonderful. And I'm going to tweak a little bit the color of this, so the fill, select radial gradient like that. And I'm going to tweak the colors, something like this. Great. Press OK. And now if I open this under ellipse, you will find gradient fill in here. Select the pointer tool. And in here have these tiny circles from which you can give it your look. So let's do something like this. Wonderful. And I think this looks good. The stroke, I'm going to leave it as it is, or maybe decrease it just a little bit. So maybe 5, just like that. Now we come to volumetric light. And to do that, we're going to create a new layer. So layer, new adjustment layer. And then we're going to find a quick effect in here named CC radial blur. So simply drop it right over there. We're going to increase the amount immediately so that we can see what we are doing. And we're going to change this to fading zoom, just like that. And most likely I would like to increase this quite a bit. So 150, you can see already the volumetric light effect in here. Now, one thing that we can see is that we lost all the detail when it comes to the motion graphics. And to add that back, we can simply find a new effect named CC Composite, drag and drop it over that adjustment layer. And with the CC Composite, here in Composite Original, we're going to select Add Alpha. And that will add back that 2D graphic in there. I quite like how this looks. I'm just going to add one final step where we can add some glow. Let's pre-compose this. So I'm going to pick all these layers and right click and find pre-compose in here. So it's right below in here. Pre-compose, move all attributes in here, and I'm going to rename this to 3D cube light. Perfect, press OK. And let's go back now to 3D cube comp, and you can see this pre-composed in one composition. Now I'm going to add some glow. So let's create a new adjustment layer, go to glow in here and find the effect glow and drop it right over there. And you can immediately see what this does in here. I'm going to toggle switches and transfer mode. I'm going to change it to add to give it some more punch. And you can play with the threshold in here to get something that you like. So for instance, this one, this looks quite cool in here. Also increase the radius. Great, this looks quite nice. Now, one final thing that we can do is we can go to project in here. And as you can see, you can find this tiny box in here. And if we click on that, under color in here, under project settings, we can increase this to, for instance, 16 bits per second, click OK, and this will give you some better results since we had some clipping issues in here. And now you can see how this whole thing looks. So that's how you make volumetric light for motion graphics. Now we can jump to footage. So we have this example in here. it's going to be fairly simple. So what we're going to do, the same thing, we're going to go to new and adjustment layer, and let's add DCC radial blur. We are going to change this to fading zoom and increase this to around 100 maybe. And then you're going to pick the center in here and move it to wherever you want the light to come from. So for instance, from here, that looks great. And of course, right now we're just seeing the light. So what we need to do is simply change this to add or screen. Most likely screen would work better in this case. You can immediately see the volumetric light over our footage in here. And the cool thing about this is that it works really well with silhouettes. And you can simply add this adjustment layer to different compositions to add that volumetric light. Now, to take this a step further, we can add some mist. So to do that, I'm simply going to add a new layer. So layer, new, solid. Let's rename this to mist, press OK, and we're going to bring in a new effect named Fractal Noise. Drag that in. We are going to increase the complexity to 20 in here, to the full amount. Wonderful. And under transform, we're going to increase the scale to be quite high, something around this size. One thing that I like to do is offset. So let's unzoom in here. Is make this mist move just a little bit. So we can keyframe the offset turbulence in here at the start of the timeline. So toggle the stopwatch on in here. Now we can move to the end. If I hit U on my keyboard, I can see that keyframe that I have made. And if I go to the end of the composition in here, now I can simply scrub this a little bit in here. And now we can see this subtle, if we play this, the subtle movement of that mist. Of course, now it is static, so it looks quite unrealistic. So to change that, I'm going to tweak the evolution as well. And I'm going to go to make a quick expression in here, hold Alt on your keyboard and click on the stopwatch on evolution. And it will open your expression settings in here. And I'm simply going to type time times 10. It will basically multiply the value of the time by 10 in here. So as time increases, the value will change in here. And now you can see that those tiny clouds kind of evolve in here. And if that's not enough, you can of course change this to something like, let's try 50. And you can see now that it changes more in here. That's a bit more than I would like. Let's change this to maybe 20. We are going to reduce a little bit the contrast in here to around this. What we can do is we can use a track matte feature in here so that we can cut this light by this mist. So let's go to track matte in here. If this is not available for you, toggle the switches in here. So go to your adjustment layer that has the radial blur on it. Go to track matte and choose mist. Great. And we are going to change the alpha matte. We're going to change this to luma matte. So we can toggle this box in here to change it to luma matte. As you can see, the icon has changed in there as well. And as we change this, you can see what happens in here. As you can see, now we have that tiny cloud detail in here, tiny mist that give it more realism. There we go. Of course, you can even increase the mist amount by, for instance, increasing the brightness and increasing the contrast. And as you can see now, you can see that mist even more, if you would like to see that more. Now, one final thing that we can do is we can even add some particles. So if I go to project in here, I have some particles set up. So under volumetric light in here, I have some atmospheric particles. And if I drag those in there, you can see that it gives it a nicer feel as well. And you can see those tiny particles right over there. Now, if you would like to see how we can create these atmospheric particles, we are going to make a tutorial on this as well, on atmospheric particles, so you can follow along on our channel as well. So now I can, if I want to use this for different scenes, I can as well. I can simply select all of those, layers in there, copy, Command C on my keyboard, and I can go to a different scene, for instance this one, Command V on my keyboard in here, and immediately you can see how this scene changes. Of course, I need to tweak from effect controls and the radial. I need to tweak from where that light comes from, right in here, and I can even tweak the light rays amount in there, etc. And for this scene, maybe we can drop a little bit the contrast. We can even tweak a little bit the color of this. So to do that, I'm going to effects and presets, get curves, an effect named curves. And with this effect, we can go, for instance, to the blue channels and increase the blue like that. And you can see how we can make this more cinematic and give it our own look using these light rays. So let's see how this looks. Great. So, and in here, if I can even solo like this footage, and we can see a before and after of this one. And as you can see, the volumetric light gives such a nice effect to this layer, to this footage. And we can even go to this one and see that as well. So that's it, guys. In another video, we are going to explore how we can create these atmospheric particles. So feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you can, you can also click like and even comment below. This will help us to reach more people in YouTube with our video tutorials that we are releasing weekly. Thank you very much for watching.